to take this this opportunity to welcome all of you to this very special get-together here tonight. And I especially am honored to have the choir Trinity to be here with us for such a wonderful event. You know, thinking about this event and really its purpose to gather such a cross-section of community for another community, and to partner with the Knights for those in Haiti so much in need. You know, when I think of Christmas, you know, the trees, the gifts, the friendship, the family, you know, all those things come to mind, a great celebration. But what really comes to my mind is the presence of Christ among us. You know, that's what Christmas is all about. And sometimes we're not aware of it. We're not aware of that fact. And we get so involved in so much else around the celebration of the event. But I'm telling you, tonight, this is Christmas. This is Christmas. This is Christ with us in what we are about. If there's anything Christ is about, it's about the love of the lost. And that's what we are about here tonight. So he is, God is with us. And I thank you for all for bringing you here and making this Christmas. So enjoy. Thank you.
Good evening and welcome to Notre Dame. My name is Edward Bowl and I'm a senior here. I would like to take this opportunity to personally thank each of you for coming to Glad Tidings and for supporting Healing Haiti's Children. For those of you that are not familiar with Healing Haiti's Children, it is a charity run by the Knights of Columbus, which is working to provide prosthetics to every child who lost a limb in the devastating earthquake of 2010. Although the earthquake happened nearly 3 years ago, its effects are still felt among the people of this impoverished nation, especially the young. And we must remember these brave children in our hearts, not only during this joyous season of giving, but all year round. Your support tonight will give the children of Haiti a chance at a brighter future, which is the greatest gift of all. There are a few groups I would like to thank this evening for making this event so special. I would first like to thank Notre Dame High School and its entire staff for the unending support that they have given, especially Brother James Brannigan, Mr. Patrick Clifford, Mrs. Kathy Wilk, Mr. Steve Kirk, the advancement staff, the Fine Arts Department led by Mr. David Roach, and all our student volunteers who have made the evening go so smoothly. Thanks to the Knights of Columbus for all their support, including Mr. Chuck Lindbergh and Mr. Peter Sonsky of the Supreme Council, and Mr. Ralph Grandpre and the Connecticut State Council for all of their hard work and support this evening. I would also like to recognize the talented musicians that you see on stage this evening. Our orchestra, which is comprised of members from all over Connecticut and the metropolitan New York area, the Trinity Choir of Men and Boys under the direction of Walden Moore with assistance from Andrew Cotillo, John Taylor Ward, our baritone, and the musicians from Notre Dame High School who are performing this evening. Finally, there are two more people I would like to thank tonight, and they specifically told me this morning not to, but I'm going to do it anyway. I'd like to thank my parents, Betsy and Ray Vogel. Mom and Dad, this past year has been a great adventure, and I want to thank you for being with me every step of the way and cheering me on and up when I needed it most. This concert wouldn't have even been without your love and support, and I thank you from the bottom of my heart for that.
Yeah, thank you.
It is now my Dostoevsky, Communications Manager for the Supreme Council of the Knights of Columbus.
Gesture. fortunate to encounter a group that had been established there called Project Medishare. They were based in Miami, and so they were very quick to be on the scene. And they have a team that works especially with problems. And through this fortuitous meeting, the group decided that they would partner, if you will, to assist those who lost lenders as a result of this hurricane, and especially the young. Not only did they decide to provide those prosthetics, but this partnership has actually led to a clinic where the prosthetics are fitted and a facility where the prosthetics are manufactured in Haiti. Now you have to remember that Haiti is a third world nation. Their culture is much different from ours. They don't view incidences like this in the manner that we do. The people who are maimed, I was sharing earlier with some guests, people that are maimed or injured in this way in Haiti are thought to be cursed. They're thought to be punished, if you will, and ostracized. So a part of the Knight's mission, along with Project Medishare, is to help them emerge not only from the wounds that they suffered in terms of the earthquake, but also in emerging from a culture that has limited their understanding of a loss of limb, meaning that a person is no longer able to live a fulfilling life. Now, part of what we've done in addition to the clinic and to the facility for the manufacturer is that we've sponsored a soccer team. A soccer team called Teams Are. It's made up of all amputees. Now, last summer, the Knights of Columbus conducted an essay contest throughout the entire nation. And Ned was the winner of our contest. Shadow of our headquarters building. But anyway, a part of the reward or the prize that went along with winning the essay contest was a trip to the Knights of Columbus International Convention, which last year was in Denver. But Team Zarian, members of Team Zarian, were present, which is where Ned had the exposure to them. And, you know, they're very joyful people, men and women on the soccer team. They are filled with exuberance. Despite the trials that they have, despite the conditions in which they live. They came to the United States, and we brought them as emissaries. They went to the Walter Reed Medical Facility in Bethesda, Maryland first, and they worked with men and women who had been injured in the line of service, many of them from Iraq, to show them how they have overcome, if you will, the devastation of the injuries, the psychological devastation of their injuries. And they played soccer with them, and they introduced them to the game. And they actually had an exhibition, which was very beautiful. They had a demonstration at the Washington, it's a professional soccer match while they were there, and then they came here to Connecticut and went to New York and had exhibitions in Connecticut and New York as well. And they were a tremendous representation from their nation, but they also sent a message back home that we have accomplished something. We lost limbs, and yet we've been selected to go and represent our nation to the most powerful nation in the world. And they represented it very well. So I want you to know that the work that we're doing there an awful lot to the people as individuals, but to the nation as well, and helping them to emerge, helping them to realize the beauty and the dignity of life and the meaning that it has, despite the fact that it might be here. I want to thank Brother James and the faculty, the administration of Notre Dame High School for this marvelous event, to Ned, to the performers tonight. It's a wonderful event. I thank you most of all for your support of this cause. also a time to